Social media use in today's age is a serious problem, especially among young people. The lifestyle of scrolling and swiping for hours and hours just to see other people's life sets up for mental health issues and facilitates anxiety and depression. Checking your phone just to what's going on Instagram destroys your presence in the moment and mindfulness. And using most social media platforms, there's a big risk regarding the brain's motivation and reward system in terms of dopamine. In this video, I'm going to talk about how the present in your real life is way more important than any social media platform, for example Instagram, TikTok, or even YouTube, and that you need way deeper activities, setting up for a longer attention span than any of these platforms can give. By watching this, you will get an understanding of how to use social media platforms in a healthy way and how to make sure you're not abusing it. Like this video to help the YouTube algorithm and subscribe to my channel to get more self-improvement and fitness videos. My name is MixTheFysik and I'm posting videos in, for example, muscle building, aesthetics, strength and health. And in self-improvement, I for example post about masculinity, presence, life setup, and mindset. The rise of social media in the last 15 years has made a big impact on the world, particularly the last 2 to 5 years, with way more people using Instagram and TikTok. This planet has really experienced the cost of that these platforms exist and are used in enormous amounts. People are stimulating the brain with these platforms. They can get instant access to anywhere in the world. You can start scrolling on Instagram at the middle of a night, in your work time, or at a social event. Basically, Instagram is an interruption from deep work, learning, and presence. In addition, seeing lots of pictures and videos from other people gives a significant degree of mental fuckery to your brain. Sorry for saying that, but this is really accurate. The way people in this age, particularly young people, use TikTok or Instagram, it has a real impact on mental health and development in this world. We want young people to chase dreams, play sports, do activities that grow them up, and play and socialize with other people, not stare at the phone for hours stimulating their brain. However, as social media is used by most people, it takes up time and energy you can use on deep work, doing physical activity, developing skills, and staying social in the real world. In the same way, you want to surround yourself with people who are social, present in the moment, assertive, and committed to their tasks. Not people who keep their attention on their phone, not doing anything productive. Social media by itself isn't the biggest part of the problem. It's actually what you lose by over-consuming it. You need challenging, competitive, and testosterone-inducing activities with a frame in the real world. You grow by problem-solving, reciprocation, goal orientation, and activities setting up for growth, not by shallow, easy tasks social media sets up for. The biggest problem is that you overstimulate your brain by staying too much at social media. Just like video games and drugs, social media overrides your brain's perception of getting a reward for low effort. Your brain perceives a reward from seeing a picture in your social media feed. And by this, you overload your dopamine receptors. By scrolling down on Instagram, you get too many impressions per time unit, and doing this for hours and hours manipulates how your brain works. This gives too much stimulation to your brain for the minimal effort you need for scrolling through stories and posts. As the content on Instagram is shallow and has no link to your presence in the real world, this is extreme degrees of consumerism. With overfilled dopamine receptors, you worsen your brain's pathways, motivation, compulsion, and perception of pleasure. This has several links to addiction in medical terms, and if your brain is conditioned to consume social media content, you have a social media addiction. Every time you see a picture or a video on Instagram or TikTok, your brain perceives a reward. And when it does this way too often, you increase your dopamine levels to really high levels. When your levels are beyond normal levels, you diminish your motivation and attention to real world tasks. Consuming Instagram in this way is what we can call empty stimulation. It is a way too big reward for little effort. It becomes social media abuse, and it has an effect on your brain in the same way as drugs, video games, and emotional eating. In addition, I think the use of social media has a toxic effect on most people. It creates jealousness from watching what other people are doing. When you scroll down to your Instagram feed, you need to understand that this is only a small section of other people's lives, and this is a highlight they want to post. Being present and grateful in your real life, you will understand the value of your life, and you will not be consumed by pictures and videos from people you follow at Instagram. You have likely lived at many different places, worked at many places, been at many different schools, or partied with lots of people. You probably have a huge network of people from all these places, and you might follow these people on Instagram. However, I really think this is a big illusion of a huge network in today's modern age. Hundreds of people you have been at the same university with, but don't have a real connection to. It is not worth to use your energy to consume the content of all them on Instagram. If you meet them in real life, either on the street or at a nightclub, have some good conversations, some hugs, and some laughs. But I think the case of losing lots of energy on consuming somebody's content, but having no real relationship or not meeting this person face to face in like 2 years is really toxic. You should really reconsider your following list on Instagram. If you don't have the number of this person on your phone or are not even friends with them on Facebook, maybe this person is not important to use energy on. Using social media in a healthy way might be a positive thing. For example, I can see figures about self-improvement where I get to know theory about topics like social intelligence and figures helping with the visualization of the real world. In addition, on YouTube, you can get deep knowledge about topics like it was a school lecture, important information for your work, mindset therapy, or information about social skills. Unlike 99% of the content on TikTok, videos on YouTube are more deep and set up for a longer attention span. If you watch videos with more comprehensive information to get a better understanding of the world and actually manage to use it for your own self-development, it's actually social media use that is valuable for your goals. In addition, you can download YouTube videos on your phone, and by that you can listen to these videos while you are walking in the woods, doing some shallow office work, or lift weights in the gym. This means that you can learn things while you are on your feet or doing something else. You don't need to be in a reading room or in the office to study. If you use social media just to see shallow content, like most TikTok videos, you are only consuming your brain with garbage. Unlike what I said about the jealousness effect from social media, it actually gives you the possibility to keep up contact with people you cannot talk to in the real world. You can message or keep video conversations with your friends through Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. That's actually one of the healthy advantages of these platforms. You can use these to keep contact with people you can't keep contact with physically. Old people, people who have moved away from you, or the opposite, and a network from different places you have been. You can use Snapchat to save and share some old moments, give a place for memories from your life you will never get back. I think the main way to use Instagram while avoiding all these toxic effects is to use it to be a producer, not a consumer. To be a leader, not a follower or an audience. And the basic rule for this is to have a focus on your own content and sell yourself and probably your business products you can earn money with. So use social media to focus on developing your own photos, videos and captions, focusing on your own presence and how you can create value for an audience. And of course, keeping contact with people you can't have in real life. People who are using social media only to consume content and never produce anything is the root of the overstimulation problems. You should use it for a purpose. If you use Instagram to market your business, you obviously need to use it. There's no way around it, but don't use a status as a content creator as an excuse to abuse the platform by being there for endless amounts of time. Very few people actually manage to use social media without severely overdoing it. I myself am a content creator, and I have posted fitness stuff since 2018, and I have educated an audience in terms of captions that are written for the reader. If you should use Instagram with a producer mindset, you should have a focus on taking photos in your real life, write captions somebody else can learn something from, and develop your presentation skills. It's actually a place to market yourself and the drive for whatever you are doing. You should likely have a time limit on how much you can use social media each day. Using social media less frees up energy you can use for other things. You need to stay committed to your tasks in terms of learning, work, and social reciprocation. When you stay at Instagram for a limited time, like half an hour each day, the negative effects will be minimal. Maybe you can stay there for an hour if you have an active profile you need to keep up. My weekly average from the last week is between 30 and 40 minutes, but I'm most likely over the point of diminishing returns for my effort both at Instagram and YouTube. This is relatively little for a person with over 2,000 followers. However, I think I use Instagram too much to follow people I don't know in the real world, and this is a very common effect of severe Instagram use. It really needs mastery and willpower to keep your attention off from Instagram and other social media platforms. You should not delete the app on your phone unless you have an extreme addiction. You need to learn to regulate yourself by being motivated by the present in the real world. If you are committed to your tasks in the physical world and committed by what's going on there, you will keep yourself off from Instagram by yourself. If you have a big motivation for tasks in the real world, your dopamine levels are at normal levels, and it's a sign that you are not using social media too much. However, with the availability of Instagram and TikTok everywhere you go, very few people actually manage to use social media in a healthy way. You simply need to work on getting more meaning and effort into your real life, and that's the real deficit of people suffering from a social media depression. I really think the average 15 or 20 years old in the Western world has at least a mild Instagram addiction. So, to sum it up, you should use social media to achieve fulfillment, to keep contact with people, and to do social interaction you cannot do otherwise. Not to watch what other people do to get jealous of them. Be conscious about the negative effects of using Instagram in terms of overstimulation of the brain's dopamine systems. And finally, make sure you are using social media, not that social media is using you. If you like this video, give it a like by pressing the thumbs up button below. Comment down below, how much social media do you use? Do you think the effect of your use is dangerous for you? And subscribe to my channel if you want more videos inside self-improvement and fitness. Thank you all for watching, and see you in the next video.